The next day, I went to Polly's like we arranged.
So what, Tom? What's with the sudden change of heart? I didn't think you wanted to do it.
That was when I still thought that Salieri wasn't using us. Now I know that he is.
Well, you're certainly right there. So would you do the bank?
What about Sam?
Hey, you heard him. He's worried about what might happen and the Don coming after us. So if you want to do it, it's just you and me. What do you have to say?
First, I'd like to see this bank. Then I'll listen to your plan.
Fine. We can go and look at it right now.
Okay, let's go.
Follow me. I'll take the train. It ain't far.
Aside from the last few jobs, pretty boring. Of course, my kid keeps things interesting.
You know, I actually envy you. I gotta find a date and start making babies. When I look at my life, I don't seem to be doing much. Hang out, go to parties. I'm getting pretty bored with it. Problem is, I don't know how to do anything else.
I think most people would like to change.
Everybody imagines the adventures and dough they see in movies. It's nothing about the boring deal-making. Always having to negotiate deals with people, and I can't make notes of anything because of the cops. Just have to remember all of them. I ain't 20 no more, and I'm starting to forget. Sometimes I don't know who promised me what or what I want. And as a result, someone always messes with me, and I lose out on the dough. It just pisses me off.
Well, we still have the excitement.
Well, that's the worst. Nothing happens for 6 months. I start to get lazy, and suddenly, boom, there's a match. Don't think any worries something might happen.
So what are we supposed to do?
This will be our last big job. Maybe enough to get me a pizzeria someplace. Or something.
Oh, really?
Wait a minute.
Mm-hmm. Good day.
Yes, please?
I'd like to take out $5.
And your name is?
Vic Comini.
Unfortunately, sir, your account is overdrawn.
What's that supposed to mean? That's it! I'm through with this bank!
I can't disagree with you there, sir.
Go to hell!
Okay. We'll start hearing the horn. We'll run in here and shout that it's a raid. Those two guards will probably just give up. If they want to play heroes, we'll liquidate them. As soon as they're out of the way, we gotta get the keys to the safe. We'll have to find out where they are from the clerks. I think they'll talk for guns at their heads. You go through that door behind the counter after you get the key. The door leads to a corridor. On the right is a staircase down to the safe and upstairs to the office. You have the keys, go straight to the safe. Otherwise, you'd have to get them somewhere upstairs. Downstairs, there will probably be more security guards. You'll have to deal with them alone while I keep everything in check upstairs. Downstairs, there's a large safe that you got unlocked. Then you just gotta get the dough and get out. That's everything.
Okay.
Let's go. You better get out of here.
My name is
goodbye.
Big Fun Park in Hoboken. You know, restaurant, dance hall, picture house.
The bank is connected to the home security system. Even with radio, cars can't get here for 5 minutes. That means we'll have 5 minutes from the time we get in to do everything and then disappear. We'll need some wheels. It's stupid to get a car from Ralphie, because he'll tell Salieri. You'll have to get a good, fast set of wheels, Tommy. For you, that shouldn't be a problem.
No, it shouldn't. I think Lucas would know something.
Okay. Try to get something fast. We'll need it. I guess they won't just let us leave. Even if we get out of the bank in time, we could still meet the cops in the city.
And how do you want to deal with them?
Head to an abandoned joint right in Hoboken. It has Palmero Club written on the wall.
Great.
There's still a little problem with guns. I have my own stuff, but you don't. We'll need to get some kind of heater. I think I know a place you can pick one up.
Where's that?
It's pretty far. It's probably best to go by train. Get on here and then go to Hoboken.
Get off at the Central Hoboken Station. I'm going the direction from which you came by the train, to the nearest crossroads.
Under the elevated railway, there's a road. Follow that and turn left at the next road. You'll see an old movie house called the Twister. At the side entrance, you'll find Yellow Pete's shop. Tell him I sent you. He should have something.
I'll do that now. I'll get some weapons, then the car, then I'll stop by your place.
Yeah. Pull in front of the building and honk your horn. The janitor's always locking the door. I'll come down and we'll go. I'll see you later.
Polly sent me.
Oh, come in.
Okay. Son, what brings you here?
Polly sent me. I need some weapons.
Right. Polly. Yeah, I know him. At least I think I know him. That short, moody guy, right?
You could say that.
Still working for Salieri?
Yeah.
Well, give that old Goomba my regards.
Sure. Anyway, the weapons.
Sure. Yeah, so what does Polly need?
That should be everything.
Great. I won't keep you from your work, son. Now you say hello to Polly for me, huh?
Sure. Thanks.
Thank you.
Hey, Luca, I need a powerful car. Fast.
Wow. Hey, I was just about to call you. I also need a quick favor, and a car I have for you is definitely worth it.
What do you need?
I promised to bring some guy a delivery, and I can't get out of the shop today. Hey, could you take it to him?
Okay. I ain't done no deliveries yet, sure.
Now make sure nothing happens to the guy before you give it to him. He's passing it on to someone else, and if something happens to him, the whole deal's ruined.
And is something likely to happen?
Well, you know, you never can tell.
Where do I find this guy?
On the plot under the hoisting bridge crossing the downtown. His name's Dick. Before you give it to him, make sure you ain't followed. Here it is.
Thank you.
Jesus, Lucas. That was a close one.
And what happened?
As soon as I got there, some hoods wanted to beat on us.
Is Dick all right? Did you give him the package?
Yeah, no problem. We took care of them together. And then he took off someplace.
Oh, thank God. Oh, you don't know how grateful I am. I have a real beauty for you now. It's an American car from a German manufacturer. That's the best around these days.
Well, certainly worth the risk. Where can I find it?
Yesterday I overheard a customer. Today, around this time, he's usually driving from Oakwood Junior High School to a meeting somewhere on Central Island. Then, follow him in where he parks, and simply take the car. Now, the locks will be your only problem. But I know you'll manage him, no trouble.
Thanks, Lucas. Can't wait.
Thank you.
Hey, that Yellow Pete is a little nuts.
He's an old loony, but his stuff's good.
Why they call him Yellow?
You see his teeth? They're the yellowest in town. And they also stink the most.
Right.
Okay, everybody. This is a heist. You're down on the floor, nothing will happen to you.
I said on the floor, everybody.
Deal with the guard. Now, you bastard.
Okay, I like it. Nice and cool. Everything will be hunky-dory.
I want the keys to the safe and make it quick. Where are they?
Sir, the keys to the grating are here, but only the manager has keys to the safe.
What? Where can I find the manager?
He's upstairs, in his office.
Okay, find the keys and get the dough fast, man.
Leave me alone, please!
The keys to the safe.
They're there in the cupboard. Just don't kill me. I have a family. I have a wife and kids. Don't do it. Leave me alone, please.
Wow. Stop screaming! Stop right now! Nobody move!
Get out of here!
Change our clothes so they won't pick us up on the street. Put the dough in the briefcase.
Fine, then what?
Don't say a word to anyone. Sleep on it. Stop by tomorrow and think about what we're gonna do with the dough. I'll take it with me, so Siren will find it. You know?
Just don't run off with it.
Sure. I'll take off to Hawaii.
Don't try it. I'd find you and stuff that metal-plated briefcase down your throat.
I'm looking forward to it.